Hey, what's going on? Rafael Hoffman. I hope all is going well with you guys listening. In this video, we're getting to Stage Coral's multiple personalities and what that means. Like, DID, like, what does that even entail? So it entails that everyone on the planet has many different energies going on within them. They have many different preferences. And everyone's encouraged by a societal dynamic for the sake of identity, for the sake of security, to be a certain way. But if you were sensitive and allowed a kind of spiritual empathy to be a part of your being, what's going to be easily discernible is that you are not one thing. You're kind of changing all the time. And you're adapting and you're becoming something different and you're evolving faster than you may think. And the ones who kind of don't do that are actually those who've adjusted to being able to fit into a box, gotten used to it, and they kind of suppress perhaps their own emotions, their own feelings. So what this entails is that everyone has some form of DID. This is contrary to what's online, where you only see about something like 0.2% of people in the whole world. No, it's like 0.002% of people who get diagnosed. But when you factor in people who are not diagnosed and people who are not sure and they're embarrassed, it's probably closer to 1%, let's say. Or closer to, let's say, 0.1% to be nice. Because not to sound too crazy by making a radical statement. But when you look at people who are depressed, what you would find is that they're not okay with that circumstance. And what's often going on is that different circumstance comes up that they don't like, but another part of them likes, but they feel they have to make this entire being's happiness dependent on this circumstance and not that circumstance. It's a lack of acceptance. So by the time you reach coral, well, the time you reach turquoise, you've already reached a certain level of acceptance. Now, in Stage Coral, the way I understand it is they start to realize that the reason why they have acceptance is because they have many different parts of themselves that they're allowing to appreciate that moment for what it is. They're allowing the disturbances not to be a sign of weakness, sign of frailty, a sign of illness, sign of internal turmoil, but rather a sign of different needs at different times. It's not judging yourself anymore for being how you are. And so what gets realized in Stage Coral is multiple personalities. Now, how does that phenomenon transfer into Stage Teal? Stage Teal takes that self-awareness and it evolves with it. So now that they're focused on building instead of dismantling, that skill to make it less noticeable reaches a high level of success. The same way throughout history, lower stages in their chaotic states, like beige to purple and red to blue, they started out as chaotic. They didn't know what to do with that energy. They didn't know what to do with their energy of hunts. You know what? We can create a tribe out of it. And red, we don't know what to do with our energy of dominance. You know what? We can create a self-controlled society. You know, it's like you're taking the ideas and you're applying it to the next stage, you know, in just an evolutionary way. And so same thing here. You had that inner turmoil, it's not painful. You had the different beliefs in your own heart that you're just letting yourself be in this situation. You're letting yourself be in that situation. And you're not judging yourself for it. You don't need to fit into society. You're realizing that you're many different personalities. And if you're really smart and spiritual, the coral will say, you know what? These personalities are actually you guys, the ones watching. These personalities, these wills, these desires are creatures or living creatures who are living today in real bodies in some shape or form. And their energy permeates the atmosphere and goes also into me. So the desire is fluctuating between every man on earth. because who you are in the mirror, it's not you. You're one particular interpretation of who you are. And so that energy is not just in your body, it's mostly in your body, but it gets permeated, goes into different people, and those people get the same desires as you. Because, why? Because you are them. Or you are imposing or diffusing your own energy into the atmosphere, into people, and they're diffusing their energy. And so what you see in stage coral is you're actually many. You're not one, you are many. So you're gonna say, we are doing great today. What do you mean, we? Are you psychotic? Do you have schizophrenia? Do you have, what are they gonna say? They're gonna say, are you multiple personalities? Are you bipolar? Or they're gonna just keep listing mental illnesses to kind of like understand what's going on with you. But none of it is true. You always had many different natures, you just weren't in touch with it. By stage coral, you're in touch with it. But by stage teal, you're no longer in touch with it in a way that makes people feel uncomfortable. You no longer, your priority is not to dismantle, it's to create comfort zones for people. So that they, because if you did things in a way that would get you judged, you won't be able to help them. They're gonna run away from you out of fear. So teal kind of says, I don't want them to be afraid of me, and I want them to join me. I don't care that they may think I'm an alien, they may think I'm alien in some fashion, other, you know, in the sense of you're not like me, but I still want you near me, and so I will adjust my way of being for you. So that's how they manage the DID. And to say that only 1% has DID is an exaggeration. It's closer to, well, it's a very high percentage to have it, and because they get falsely diagnosed, they become depressed. They become depressed because they have other needs, and they don't know how to manage those needs. And what ends up happening is they become depressed from the conflict, or they develop different forms of depression. So whatever number of depression on the web you can find on statistics, take a larger percentage of that and add it to DID. Had they processed their situation, they would have been diagnosed with DID, and they would have expressed themselves in a way that's not to pretend they're someone else, which is a stage orange mistake, is that you act in order to channel your energy. That could help, and it could be true for those who are not diagnosed, but it's also not entirely, it's also true as well that when you act it out, you're also managing different emotions that require you to be a certain way. Not just emotions, but different parts of your psyche, different priorities, preferences. Those are a different, it's a dichotomy that's existing that you're not allowing to exist. So in stage coral, you will accept it, you will be it. And therefore, if people factor that in, many people would have DID. At least 20% of the whole world population would have DID, and the rest would already be in different structures, so they wouldn't need, they would have a way to placate the DID, because they'll have a system of making money. They'll have something that they value that's a need. They've created a belief system that says that's a need. And probably a lot of these people are stage orange, but they can't advance because they're in the systems. But a lot of them, it could be people are in yellow and turquoise and so on, that they've also managed to be in those systems in a high stage. Don't get me wrong. But a lot of these people who don't have some form of mood swings or different moods coming out, those people are, they've developed a system where they value some kind of materialistic thing. More, you know, like money is usually the big one. Something that tells the public or society that you have status by being in this position or being this person. And that enables them to kind of not have as much noticeable symptoms. Okay, so I'm making the radical claim in this video that at least 20% have it. Perhaps most people would have it had they allowed themselves to have it. And so if you go back to stage red, what you're gonna find is they were crazy. They were like seemingly psychotic. They would kill people if someone bothers them. Or so it's the reason. they had this phenomenon, just it wasn't compartmentalized, it wasn't structured, it wasn't refined. In Coral, it's very refined. This hostility is refined. You start dividing yourself up into compartments. Okay, I have anger here, I have happiness here, I have joy here, I have a soft heart here, I have an angry side there, a mean person here. That's all, fine. We'll get to each of you when the time is right. I trust the universe to organize my own emotions, to regulate it for me. And the universe does a great job. Because the universe has a natural system of flux that you cannot predict, and it's also incredibly wise, and it has to be wise in order for existence to thrive with the immense intelligence that is always operating. Now, is a red saying this? No, because they haven't evolved to the point of valuing intelligence. That happens in stage orange. That happens in stage yellow, you know? And that kind of awareness will appear in stage coral. Now, once you enter into teal, then the symptoms kind of go away, not because they're going away, but because you become an expert at applying them where it's right. And I'm guessing the universe kind of helps you in this, so you don't seem like you have symptoms, but but it's going on. Like an example is Teal Swan. I used to look at a lot of her photos back in the day, and I used to see that she has a different face, like hundreds of different faces. So a lot of her is in coral and in teal. So once you get into these high tiers, you allow yourself to be someone else. You allow yourself to channel different energies. And the best channelers obviously can speak word verbatim what the spirits are saying, but even a sub-channeler, someone who's not going into all the spiritual stuff, you will find, these people will find, that they're different from hour to hour. But with Teal Swan, you don't say she's different day to day. You know, she's entirely consistent. But if you look closely, her face is different in different pictures, because a high tier allows themselves to be different. And one of the reasons why she's not noticeable is because the stage learns to cope. It learns to apply it in a way that can build communities and not scare people away. And in coral, I think that Teal Swan, if you look back 10 years ago, I'm guessing she was probably in stage coral 10 years ago. My guess is she was more out there, and she was more maybe passionate, maybe she was more uptight. Certain traits that tend to come up for a coral who feels misunderstood. I also think she might have situations where she had mood swings. That mood swings are a misdiagnosis of stage coral. Also, if you have mood swings since a kid, does that mean you're in stage coral? So I actually am starting to believe that those who have any kind of disorder that relates to mood swings and fluctuations and happy, sad type of vibes, you're actually have an activation in your brain of stage coral. And as you arise the spiral, you will be more attuned and capable to deal with it and to learn from it and to teach about it and to actually integrate it into society in a very harmonious and helpful way, because you were raised with it. But basically, I think that's a sign of activation in higher stages. What else? So yeah, and as you go into teal, you'll naturally kind of settle down. Also, you'll have different personalities, which means that different personalities will be at different stages. And the complexity gets really significant, because why is this the case? How does this work? So I wouldn't try to make a science out of it, but it is true. So what you're going to find is you have to make averages. Like, this is who you are, and you'll fluctuate here and there. Right now I'm in teal, but sometimes I'm in coral, sometimes I'm in orange, sometimes I feel like I'm in reddish, kind of, but not really, maybe, and sometimes I feel yellow. So that fluctuation is different parts of your personality coming out. But because you're also a high tier, you're also, then you'll quickly, like a rubber band, be able to seem fully in the high tier again. So that's the tricky part that's important to keep in mind. And I guess as the higher you go, the higher the lower sides will also go. And I'm guessing the way to advance and to get your lower sides is to feel integrated into society. If you don't have a job, you don't have a future, of course you're going to be miserable, and there's going to be a devil inside of you that says you're not good enough. And that's going to manifest as rage and contempt and hatred begrudgent. But that's not who you are. That's just a byproduct of the lower of the society at large that doesn't want you to grow. It doesn't want you to be happy. It's not that the society doesn't want you to be happy. It's the energy underneath them, the energy of rage that doesn't want you to be happy. That the underlying consciousness of rage doesn't want people to be happy. That's just the way the universe is. So it's preventing an advancement in consciousness. And the way to placate that anger is very complicated. That's a separate video I mentioned in the past. But it's basically to satisfy needs, and it's to break stigmas, which is a priority of Coral, and not just a priority, but an enjoyment for them. And yeah, which is interesting because an unhealthy green might like to break stigmas, you know, the anarchy, just to fight against the system out of spite. So that's also a factor there. So an angry green can get confused for a coral and stuff like that. But you'll know an angry green is more simple minded. You'll know when someone's a coral. You'll probably have to know about spiral dynamics to be coral, because the way to advance, you have to prep your mind, heart, and body towards that direction. So it's rare. It's probably very rare for someone to be in coral when they don't know anything about spiral dynamics. The highest I've seen is turquoise and a little bit of coral. I've never seen someone who's not aware of spiral dynamics that is in coral completely, like 50% at least. I haven't seen it. Jason Silva, I think he's in stage coral, like 40-60%. And I don't know if he learned about this, but what tends to happen in turquoise is that if you spend enough time thinking about the universe's extravagance and perfection of paradox and beauty, you will start to appreciate not just the sereneness, but the chaos. And that is the segue into that kind of world. People also tend to go through depression between stages as like a way to break out of that current stage. And it's like the ego backlash between stages. So just because you have a depression or mood swing or bipolar thing, temporary, throughout the lower stages, it doesn't mean you're activating higher stages. It could just mean that you're segueing into a new stage where you'll have a higher level of EQ and serenity in that stage. And then the next stage will usher in new stuff as well. And you don't need to go through depression between stages. It just happens to be that those who are not aware of spiral dynamics require that a little more, because their ego and their soul is having conflicts, trying to work out conflicts, trying to tell you what's important, what's not important. And then that clash creates a midlife crisis. But the midlife crises don't have to happen. If you're aware that there is a growth process, you will grow. That's just how it is. You'll have clarity, and that clarity will be like an escalator, you know, a spiral escalator of ease and predictability. You'll be able to predict yourself, your moods, and that understanding will also add to more calmness. There you have it.